Hey guys, so in today's video, I am going to walk you through how to create and upload an SVG file, and specifically in Show It. And so this is Show It if you haven't used Show It before. It's a website builder that connects with WordPress, and it's amazing because it's a drag and drop editor. But if you look in the actual like editor portion of Show It at the different local files that I have here, this is an SVG file and this is a PNG file. And they don't look all that different on the actual app itself, but if you either publish your site or if you hit preview, you'll notice a big difference, especially if you have a Retina device. So on a Retina screen especially, you can see that this SVG file is really crisp. And if you look over at the PNG file, you'll see that the edges of the type especially, and then my icon, anywhere that there's more fine detailing within the logo itself, it's gonna look a little pixelated. And so we always recommend uploading an SVG file to your website if you have one. And this goes for Squarespace, this goes for a straight WordPress site, this goes for any website that you're working on. As long as the platform allows for an SVG file, and most should, that's what we recommend using. So if you don't have an SVG file or you've never made one before, I'm going to show you how to make one using both Illustrator and a free online app. So within Illustrator, you want to make sure that you're opening up the original vector file. So if your designer created something with Adobe Illustrator, or if you have a PDF, or if you have, not all PDFs are a vector, but a lot of them should be, or especially if you have an EPS file, you should be able to get the original vector logo. If you don't have a vector version of your logo, and you can tell because you'll be able to click on the individual elements, you can make things other colors if you want. If you open it up and it's all just one image and you don't have the ability to ungroup things and work on things individually, then you don't have a vector file. But if you do have a vector file, it's really easy to save it as an SVG, even if you don't have an SVG file. So if we come up and we go to File and Save As, we're gonna save it to my desktop. And you have the option down here to select from a few different formats. By default, it's probably gonna be set to Adobe Illustrator or EPS, whatever file format you opened before. But we wanna save it as an SVG file. And so give it a name, and then I'll just click Save As. And these settings, the standard settings, are all fine. And so we'll hit okay. One other thing that I want to point out is that if you, depending on how you made the logo, you also want to make sure that everything is an outline. So if you can still click on the text and edit it, that's not good for exporting as an SVG file because not all computers are going to render your fonts. So if for some reason you can still edit and select the text, you'd want to go to Object and then Expand and keep hitting Expand until the text is no longer editable. So once you have exported your file, you can just come in and upload the SVG file and it should look a lot better. It should look really crisp.
So the alternate way to create an SVG file is to use a free online converter. And so this is https://image.onlineconvert.com, and I'll put that in the notes of this video. And I know it looks super ugly, but I've tried this and I promise it works. So if you upload your PDF of your logo, and again, this is only going to work if you have the vector version of your logo. But if we choose our file, and then we can ignore all of these settings because we don't actually need to size our file. We don't need to do anything. We'll just hit convert file and it's going to run the process. And then right here is where you would download the file. And once it's downloaded, you can come back in and upload it to your website. And I tested it, and this SVG file that was created by this online converter looks just as good as my one made by Illustrator.